In the next hour and 15 minutes, you will be taken through three different kinds of presentation slash communication actually. You will be watching a short video of all the finalists, of all the Sankalp finalists. You will then be taken through an elevator pitch by each of the finalists. I will explain the rules of the elevator pitch in a short moment. And lastly, you will all be part of a panel discussion with our eminent panel, which is already seated here, which we will be inviting on stage. If I may quickly tell the finalists the rules for the elevator pitch. You will be given 1 minute in which to present your business idea and whatever else is the message that you want to convey to the panel which is seated here. At the end of 1 minute, a buzzer would go off or someone would call out time for you, and at which point you would have to stop, right? So I'm sure you've already got your stuff prepared and ready. So just make sure it's as concise, as precise as possible, and I think we're ready to go. May we have the lights dimmed, please, and the video played. Thank you. I would now like to call upon representatives of the finalists who are here with us for their elevator pitches. Let me quickly read out the order in which I will be calling you so that you're aware. Please remember, you have 1 minute to present whatever information about your business that you want to present to the audience here. I will be calling you in this order. P2 Power Solutions, first. Onergy, second. Carbon Clean Energy Solutions, third. Azure Power, fourth. Nandan Biometrics, fifth. And EnviroFit, sixth. Okay? My colleague here, Kanika, will be keeping time for us. And your time will start once you get to the podium. Okay? So can I call on Aseem of P2 Power Solutions to kindly make the start?
I'm Aseem Sidhu from P2 Power Solutions. We provide innovative engineering solutions for power quality and energy efficiency. Our clients look at us whenever they're looking at taking their enterprise to an extreme efficiency level, or whenever they're looking at effectively leveraging renewable sources along with improving the quality of power being used at their facility. We look forward to working with you and helping you achieve extreme energy efficiency levels.
Let me call Ekta Kothari of Onergy, please.
Hello, everyone. I'm Ekta from Onergy. Onergy is a renewable energy venture aiming to provide complete energy solutions across rural India in terms of lighting, cooking, and electrification. Onergy creates an ecosystem whereby we connect appropriate technology in an affordable way to the bottom of the pyramid. So our products include small, low-cost LED lights to bigger electrification systems and improved cooking solutions. So we are a distribution and servicing company, and we set up renewable energy centers in partnerships with grassroots NGOs and MFIs and reach out to the communities by training rural entrepreneurs and self-help groups. The value that we create for our customers is affordability, quality in both in terms of products and servicing, and the sort of product mix that we can offer, and the sort of customization that we offer to them, and the delivery in these services and products. Thank you.
Carbon Clean Energy Solutions. We have Anirudh from.
So before I start, small change, that's only Carbon Clean Solutions there. It's not energy, it's only Carbon Clean Solutions. Anyways, one thing that would impact the poorest 2 billion people on a planet is energy. And 80% of the energy today comes from fossil fuels that produce carbon dioxide and leads to global warming. Now, carbon clean solutions provide carbon capture technology to power plants that can reduce their emissions by 90%. Compared to any market solution today, our technology and patented solvents can reduce the cost by 25%. It's a $24 billion market today, expected to grow 5 times in the next 20 years. We have partnerships with leading research institutes, and we are building a pilot demonstration with one of the largest power producers here in India. Out of a total $1.2 million required, we have already secured $900,000, and we are now looking to close the last bit of funding. There are about 5,000 power plant boilers across the world. And just think of the difference it would make if we can reduce 90% of their carbon dioxide emissions. I am Anirudh from Carbon Clean Solutions, and I'll be available outside if you want to talk to me. Thank you.
Next, we have Nirav from Azure Power.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Nirav Rawal from Azure Power. Azure Power is a solar solutions company focusing on building and owning solar power plants, participate in off-grid and rooftop projects. It's the first private sector company to build and own a solar power plant, and it's on its way to become a leading solar power company in 2011 by commissioning 17 megawatt projects. Azure aims to deliver 100 megawatt by 2014 by having the lowest cost per megawatt having a good execution capabilities, having a complete in-house EPC capabilities as well. once this Azure is executing all this project, Azure is executing these projects in various states of India, and once these projects are completed and commissioned, a good clean energy will be produced, and the power will be supplied to many households in rural India. Thank you. Yeah.
Next, we have Mr. V. Sandeep from Nandan Biometrics.
Good afternoon, everyone. Nandan is into two sunrising segments, renewable energies and nutraceuticals, concentrating more on renewable energies, that is on biofuels and wind, the 80% on biofuels. Our long-term target is to become the world's largest player in biofuels. We have worldwide patents. We are the only company to have worldwide patents for Geotropha, and we have also IPRs for second generation biofuels. In both the segments, we are the integrated player, right from R&D to manufacturing. So whatever we do R&D, file the patents, we prove it, and we upgrade it, and we commercialize it. We are in the last stage right now. We are taking off. Thank you.
And finally, we have Mr. Harish Anshan from Envirofit.
Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. Harish Anshan from Envirofit. The problem, 50% of the world's population still cooks on biomass, resulting in 2 million deaths every year, and that's essentially women and children. The solution, clean and improved cook stoves from Envirofit. Proof of concept proved on the ground, 250,000 stoves till date, and we are looking for scaling up operation funds to bring the smiles into these women's lives. Thank you.
Thank you all. Thank you very much. We now have a short presentation on the clean energy sector by Mr. Sarvesh Kapoor of IntelliCap.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome. So this is just a presentation that would lead into the panel discussion. So just getting the context right. So how do we define clean technology? In IntelliCap, actually, we define clean technology as sustainable technology and not just clean energy. In its subsectors, we include energy generation, which is wind, solar, small hydro, etc. We also have energy efficiency and storage management, like building efficiencies, super condensers. We also have material management and alternate energies, like e-waste cycling, etc., etc. But however, for the panel discussion, we would only focus on energy generation for today. So what is the need of renewable energy sources, if we may ask so? Well, India has limited fossil fuel resources. By the latest estimates, we only have coal reserves which would last roughly around 60 years. Our oil reserves would also just last about 30 years. And to make matters worse, our average per capita consumption is one of the lowest, even compared to other BRIC countries, far, far below the other developed countries. It also adds to energy securities. We in India, as a, our consumption as a percentage of production is quite low, and we have to definitely depend on external countries for our needs. Not just that, even renewable energies can help us provide power to unserved areas. So definitely it is a very, very important area. Having said that, so how has India progressed in its quest? Well, currently it's just about 10% of our power needs that are met by renewable energy. And when you compare that with other countries, it is still definitely lesser. If you compare it with even BRIC countries, it's still less, and much lesser even than a couple of other developed countries. And is it that we don't have potential? That's not the case. Our potential is definitely far, far, much higher than what we have achieved so far. With 140 gigawatts of potential, we've just about to manage 12.5%. So when we have huge potential, so is there any way in which we could actually achieve that potential? Or rather, what are the government initiatives that have happened so far? The government initiatives actually can be broken down into three main areas. One is finance, which is ESOPs for tax breaks, etc., subsidies, and also secondly, we could break it down with whatever the energy acts, etc. are, the energy conservation acts and the electricity acts, and other initiatives by the government, like your state subsidies, etc., and also lowering of the foreign equity participation ceilings. So even when the government is making some initiatives, what are the possible roadblocks that are limiting our potential, as to say? Are we facing some scalability issues? Is it regulatory issues? Are this technology which we are lacking? Or is it just that the economics are not feasible? These are a couple of questions which the panel would ponder upon and give us some insights. Thank you.
We would now move on to the panel discussion. As Sarvesh set a bit of the context around this, I would first like to invite the moderator of this panel, Mr. V. Vineet, please. Mr. Vineet is founder of Panchabhuta, a leading independent forum for the clean tech and clean energy sector in India, and it has risen over the last year. We take great pleasure in welcoming him on stage. I would like to invite the other panelists as well. Mr. Pradeep Bhargava, Managing Director, Cummins Generator Technology, not Power Private Limited. Alan is currently the founder and chairman of Kiran Energy Solar Power Limited, a Mumbai-based solar power company. He has previously served as a member of Group Corporate Center and Group Executive Board of the Tata Group as well. Welcome. Mr. Nakul Jhaveri. Mr. Nakul is an investment manager of the Global Environment Fund. He has extensive experience in areas of energy efficiency, energy policy, carbon finance, and clean development mechanism activities. Ms. Rupa Hattangadi.